Hey everybody, Flip and Danny here, founders of the Freedom Real Estate Group family of companies, and welcome to another episode of our podcast, which is called
Freedom Through Passive Income.
That's right, and welcome to another episode, and this wraps up our series. This is episode 6 out of 6 for our series, and this series was called How Your Personality Dictates Your Returns. And today we're talking about putting it all together.
That's right.
Because 5 episodes ago, mm-hmm. we talked about how your personality affects and how it's really behind how you invest and your investing. And then the last 4 episodes, we talked about the 4 different personality types.
Yeah.
Which was interesting because we basically talked about Danny and then 3 others. which is true.
It is true.
And just real quickly, I'll go through all these, and hopefully we can have these little pictures on your screen if you're watching. If you're not, sorry, but at least I'll say them verbally so you can hear them. So type A was ambitious, competitive, practical, impatient, and aggressive.
That's me.
Yep. type B is relaxed, cheerful, patient, too casual, procrastinator. Number C. Oh yeah, I said that. Okay, letter C, or type C, I should say. Systematic, thoughtful, sensitive, cautious, critical. And type D, distressed, negative, pessimistic, depressed, socially inhibited. And so those are the 4. And so after each one, we talked about what our percentages were. And we always ask you, you know, what percentage are you of this one?
Yep.
And so we got done with the first one. Danny said she was 100%. I said you were 98%. because maybe there was a 1% of B or whatever. But
no, it's actually, I underlined it. So you had told me after the episode, he said, well, there was something in there that I said, no, she does not do that. Mm-hmm. And it was where it says they are also prone to cut people off while the other speaks. I don't do that.
Yep.
I used to, mm-hmm. But I learned by watching other people cut other people off how much it irritated me, mm-hmm. that you should just sit back, listen to what somebody has to say. And if you have something to say, take a note, like write it down so mm-hmm. that you don't forget your thought process. Because mm-hmm. I understand why people cut each other off. You say something and I have a thought process that I need to get out mm-hmm. before I forget it. And then like nobody ever gets to like, you know, actually finish their sentences. And so I don't do that anymore. And I haven't for a very long time. And I'm very good about writing things down or just waiting until people are done. And then mm-hmm. And sometimes I actually never get to speak. You know, there'll be a meeting and they'll be talking. And everything gets resolved without me saying a word. Why? Because I didn't talk over them or try to interrupt. It all happened. And I'm like, that was pretty cool.
Yep.
And then they're like, Danny, you haven't said anything. Well, I didn't want to interrupt you guys. And look, you guys solved it without me. Mm-hmm. Ta-da!
Yeah, I think I learned that from a Tony Robbins lesson. He had said that, you know, whenever you're in a conversation and somebody's talking, don't interrupt them.
Yeah.
Just let them talk.
Yeah.
And especially if they're heated.
Yes, if they're angry.
Because if you interrupt them, oh, it's just going to make it even worse.
Yep, yes, yes. And that was something actually in Texas. I can't remember. I got on a call and it was a very, very heated argument. And you and I had just had that conversation about Tony Robbins. And so I was just like, let them talk. Just let them until they can't talk anymore. And by the time they were done, they had calmed themselves down because mm-hmm. they had let it all out. And I just sat there and listened. So really great lesson. So that's why I remembered mm-hmm. why you said it was 98%. So I'm still going to put myself at 100% type A. I read type B again, and I just feel like I'm not even close. Like, the cheerful parts of it that I thought maybe I would be, you know, some of that. Right. And I am more patient than I am, than I was before, but it's a forced patience. Mm-hmm. I'm really impatient. I'm like, I want that right now. Like when I ask for something, I want it right now. Right. But then I just tell myself, sit down, breathe. It's fine if it comes tomorrow. It's fine if it comes next week. And as I grit my teeth. Yep. I'm just going to go full on 100% type A because even though I'm trying to be better in certain areas, I'm not good enough to
You still have the traits of the cheerful.
Because
People love that about you.
Yeah.
And the whole never cutting people off. I think we were in a meeting last week. And I didn't say a word for the 45 minutes we were in the meeting. And finally, at the end, they said, Flip, you don't say a word. And I said, well, I'm kind of like Teller from Penn and Teller.
That's right.
I just nod.
That's right. Okay. So we know my personality type. Yep. We'll talk about how that affects investing. But let's recap what you said yesterday. Mm-hmm. When we did type A, you said, I'm 3 out of 5. So the ones you didn't relate to was you're not impatient and you're not aggressive.
Right.
But you are ambitious, competitive, and practical.
Correct.
Okay. So you gave yourself a 50 to 60%. Mm-hmm. And I warned you that was pretty high.
Yeah, that was pretty
high. Since there was other types.
Yep.
So then we got to type B, and you again related to 3 out of 5. You didn't relate to being too casual. You didn't relate to being a procrastinator, but you related to being relaxed, cheerful, and patient. Again, you gave yourself 50 to 60%. Mm-hmm. So we're already at 120 at the top end. Just letting you know.
I'm an overachiever. That's in there somewhere.
And then we discussed type C, and you related to 2 out of 5 of those characteristics. So I believe it was thoughtful and sensitive. Mm-hmm. Is that right? Those are the two?
I believe so, yeah.
So you did not relate to systematic, cautious, and critical. So you gave yourself a 20 to 40%. So now on the high end, we are at 160%.
Sweet.
Sir Flipper. How are you going to adjust your percentages based on a mix of A and B equally and a little bit of C?
Yeah, I had to think about this long and hard. I'm going to dial back the A personality because there's the type A personality or whatever of the worker. But this type A, I would have to dial that back to 35% because I'm not that aggressive. I'm not that, I'm competitive. And I'm ambitious and I'm practical. I'm definitely not impatient and I'm definitely not aggressive at times. So I would say out of all of that, I would dial that back down to 35%. And
okay.
Then, but then B, I would put that at a 45%.
Okay.
45%. And then, so we're at 80%. So
yep.
Then I'm at 60% of part C. Just kidding. I would still say I'm 20%
okay,
of C.
20%. Yeah. All right.
So that equals 100.
Yes, it does. Okay, good job. Okay, so now let's talk about how this affects us as investors, because this entire episode series was how our personality dictates our returns, mm-hmm. right?
Yep.
So I am aggressive, ambitious, competitive, practical, impatient.
Mm-hmm.
So applying that to my style, I, unlike you, did not really care about doing the crypto or the stocks.
Mm-hmm.
I am 100% all in on real estate
mm-hmm.
because I know it. And because I know it means I get to take risks. I get to be aggressive about it because mm-hmm. I'm being aggressive with me and you, our knowledge, our capabilities. Mm-hmm. And I know that that every time we've taken a risk, it has paid off in some way, shape, or form.
Mm-hmm.
We've always won more than we've lost.
Yep.
So my type A personality goes freaking all in,
right.
No matter what, in the area you know best, and you always put 100% of all the risk and the investment in yourself because mm-hmm. that's going to give you the highest return.
Yep.
So that's how my personality affects my rate of return. So now let's talk about you, because you've got 35% of type A, mm-hmm. 45% of type B, and 20% of type C. How does that affect your investing style?
Well, I think it's funny because they said, like, when you buy stocks and crypto, that's not something, you know, that's a long term.
Yeah.
You know, so to define me is I'll do something like that, but I check it every 10 minutes.
Okay.
I lost another dollar. Right.
Okay. So how does that affect your rate of return in the long run and your maybe peace of mind?
Well, see, my peace of mind. See, I'm constantly looking because I want to see what it is, you know. I'm still patient because I want to let it ride.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the stocks that we have, they're actually growing quite a bit right now. But I'm not going, come on, let's go. You know, mm-hmm. I'm not that way. But
yeah.
I'm just like, oh, this is going to be sweet. I can't wait to watch this as it goes.
Yep.
You know, over the next whatever week, months, years.
Mm-hmm.
You know, but But I'm still along for the ride. I'm still comfortable going along on the ride with you on all of the things that we're doing. Mm-hmm. You know, so I'm not going, no, we shouldn't do that. You know, that's not right. So that's what makes it. I think that's why we work so well together.
Yeah. Well, and this takes in consideration too. We just decided to invest in Power Room, right?
Uh-huh. Yep.
And so that was a very hefty investment. Mm-hmm. And I just got off a meeting right now where we're going to be partnering with multiple people. I've talked to multiple people, and we are going to be developing some very strategic relationships mm-hmm. and partnerships. They're going to take us into a space that is going to be wild
yep.
and crazy. And I'm particularly aggressive about it because I know me and I know them, and I know that their strengths are exact opposite of my strengths. Mm-hmm. And together we're just going to freaking blow it up. And I've seen their success. They've seen our success. Mm-hmm. So it's just going to be freaking crazy.
I'm excited to learn about all this.
Yeah. But the reason I brought up the Power Room is that is opposite of real estate. So
yeah.
I loved it. I didn't, the reason I trusted that, like I trust in real estate, is because of the people, mm-hmm. right? I've seen their success, and I know that the more we level up and surround ourselves with people who are doing things 10, 20, 50 times greater than mm-hmm. we are, the more sure I am of our ability to continue to mm-hmm. grow and yeah. do great things, not just for us, but for everybody else who goes, mm-hmm. I want to be on the Flippin' Dani train, and I want to do what they're doing because yep. they're spending the time to surround themselves with the right people, do all the research. They're putting their money and lives on the line mm-hmm. 100% in everything that we do. So when you see people go all in and they trust themselves like that, and you've seen their track records, mm-hmm. like, it's a game changer. So now you know how I feel about the Power Room and why. So why were you confident about the Power Room, knowing that you're different personality type?
Yeah, it was funny too when they asked us. It was like you looked at me like, "What do you think?" Because you were all in way before you even asked me. You know, what do you think? And I'm just like, and I could tell by the look in your eyes, you just wanted to see what I thought, and yeah. I was all in because I wasn't worried about the amount that we were investing. I wasn't worried about any of that. I knew what we were investing in. Mm-hmm. You know, I knew the people that we were investing in, and I had seen that for over a year, and I knew and heard the stories of them before we met them, and have been watching them since we met them.
That's right.
And there was zero doubt of I want to be in that. I want to be a part of that. I want to, you know, we want to throw our hats into the ring for that because, you know, 2-3 years ago, if you would have told us what we're doing now, I wouldn't have believed it.
Yeah.
But we've always taken little steps, mm-hmm. and every little step has been easier and easier and easier to take.
Yeah.
And like you said, we're going to blow it up. You know, you're talking about stuff that I don't even know about. but again, tell us that 4 or 5 years ago, you're like, are you kidding me?
Yeah.
You know, how did we get there?
Yes.
You know, going from step one to step 300, you can't see it.
That's right.
But we're taking every little step at a time.
That's
and
right.
So, yeah, no, I had zero doubt when they talked to us about Power Room. I was all in, hook, line, and sinker.
It's the people. We yep. trust the people.
Absolutely.
Yeah. Yep. I love that. Okay. So your job at this point is to do the same evaluation Flip and I just did mm-hmm. With ourselves. We did it with you so that you kind of see how we have conversations and how we talk to each other, how we, I don't know, apply conversations like this to our lives mm-hmm. and our investing styles so that we can learn a little bit. This is what Flip and I do. Like, every night at dinner, we'll have conversations like this.
Yep.
Half of the podcasts that we do are just dinner conversations that we go,
We're just not eating here.
We should share that. So I hope that you guys got a lot out of this episode. What's important to me is that you take action from the stuff that we're doing, because us learning about our personality types has allowed us to take action in different areas because we became more confident by talking about it, mm-hmm. right? And then realizing what we think we needed in order to take steps forward. Mm-hmm. So if you've learned something about what your personality needs in order to feel comfortable with investing, then take the next step, whatever that is. If it's investing with us in real estate, then go on to Freedom Capital Investments and join the investor club. That's how you get in touch with our investor relations team. You're going to talk to CJ, you're going to talk to Ben, and they're going to answer any and all of your questions. So all of you type C people who I love having on my team, mm-hmm. who just ask every question in the world, it's okay. That's what they're there for. They're there to answer all of your questions so that you can, you know, peel back the onion and learn everything that you want to learn, and don't invest until you're comfortable. That's mm-hmm. that's a strong, you know, message that we always say, because when you're comfortable, you feel good. You sleep good at night. So, yep. Yeah, join our investor club or find investments you're comfortable with. That's your call to action today.
I don't even need to say it this time. That's yeah. awesome. Yeah. Okay. But make sure you're also checking us out on all the social medias, because Ben and CJ are over there as well answering yep. your questions. So make sure, like you said, type C people get all those questions in, but the type B and A people can get your questions in too.
Yes, you just won't have as many as type C.
Exactly. Well, we hope that you enjoyed this episode, and we like to end all of our episodes with
Invest Smart,
Live Happy.
Bye everybody.
Nothing on this show should be considered specific, personal, or professional advice. Please consult an appropriate tax, legal, real estate, financial, or business professional for individualized advice. Opinions and information on the show are not guaranteed. All investment strategies have the potential for profit and loss.